Well, Joe Rogan has had quite the year, and 2021 is the year where I feel as if we can safely say he's gone full-blown conservative. I mean, he already was kind of flirting with more reactionary opinions with regard to trans issues. He brought on transphobic guests. He'd oftentimes have a take that was just bad and right-leaning. But this year, I mean, the transformation is complete. He's even posting old boomer memes on his Instagram page from like back in 2012 or 2013. He shared this recently. The year is 2034. The cash me outside girl is president. And there are 67,298 genders. It's illegal to have a opinion. I'm the last straight male. This is my story. Now, you know that this meme is old as hell, because since that meme was made, we've had Donald Trump as president, who I'd argue makes the cash me outside girl, now known as bad baby, look like Einstein. I would much prefer bad baby over Donald Trump when we're talking about, you know, presidential politics. I don't even know what she believes in. I don't even know if she has a political ideology, but at least she's more intelligent than Donald Trump. But I mean, that's not all, because Joe Rogan has also posted fascist apologia on his page. But I mean, to be fair, he's not just sharing right-wing memes on his Instagram page. He frequently shares pictures of his beautiful doggo. So I mean, I guess we're even, maybe. But I mean, to be clear, he doesn't have the reach on Instagram that he has on his platform. And honestly, even if him becoming a right winger is bad, and people who are seemingly apolitical who tune in might be influenced by that, what really makes it problematic, what makes his podcast bad, is the fact that he is promoting misinformation when it comes to the COVID-19 pandemic and COVID-19 vaccines. Now, these don't just make people dumber, these episodes. These episodes actually make people do stupid things that endanger their lives. So there's a lot of things that Joe Rogan has said this year that I think really solidify his move to the right. Now, maybe there's other things that influence this, external factors, him moving to Texas, him getting the Spotify deal, him getting exponentially more wealthy. I don't know, but Media Matters compiled a very comprehensive list of all of the right-wing takes that Joe Rogan has had this year, and boy, has he had a lot of really shitty takes. But mostly what I want to focus on is the COVID-19 misinformation. So this is a quick refresher of all of the bad COVID takes that Joe Rogan has had throughout 2021, and I shouldn't even say it's all of the takes. It's not a comprehensive list. I can't go over all of these, but it's some of the most dumb takes he's had with regard to COVID-19. Alex Patterson of Media Matters writes, on April 23rd, Rogan encouraged healthy young people not to get a COVID-19 vaccine, saying, if you're like 21 years old and you say to me, should I get vaccinated? I'll go no. On June 22nd, Rogan dedicated an entire episode of his podcast to promoting ivermectin as a prophylactic and therapeutic for COVID-19, even though it's an unproven and potentially dangerous treatment for the disease. On August 6th, Rogan fear-mongered that vaccine passports would move the U.S. one step closer to dictatorship, and lied that getting the coronavirus vaccine is not effective in preventing the disease, saying all you hear is take this vaccine. That doesn't even prevent you from getting the disease, or you can't go to the sauna or wherever the fuck you want to go. If it was a vaccine, it's more of a treatment than it is a vaccine, really, if you look at it. That's dumb. On August 12th, Rogan promoted the baseless right-wing narrative, fear-mongering that immigrants crossing the U.S.-Mexico border were causing a surge in COVID-19 cases, saying they're letting in, so Greg Abbott, the governor, the great governor of the state of Texas, wow, was correct. They're letting in thousands and thousands of people who are positive with COVID-19. How would you know that? What? On August 20th, he falsely asserted that mRNA coronavirus vaccines are really gene therapy and lied that it is not logical, it's not rational, and it's not supported by science advise people with natural immunity to get a coronavirus vaccine. On September 23rd, Rogan fearmongered that vaccine passports will lead to a social credit system similar to what they have in China. Jesus Christ. On September 20th, Rogan baselessly suggested that President Joe Biden did not actually receive a COVID-19 vaccine booster shot, falsely claiming that it would be unsafe and potentially deadly to do so on live TV. I didn't even see this one. On November 10th, he repeatedly spread the baseless claim that the Biden administration is trying to stop people from receiving monoclonal antibodies, a COVID-19 treatment, because it discourages people from getting vaccinated. Full Alex Jones here. On November 22nd, Rogan falsely asserted that children do not need to get a COVID-19 vaccine, saying they're trying to say that children need it when they don't. They don't need it. So not only did he shift to the right throughout 2021, sharply so, it's also clear that COVID-19 just broke his brain. The pandemic broke his brain. I mean, he used to be pro-vaccine. He used to not necessarily know a lot about science, but he'd bring on people who know more than him to talk about these things. And now he's just spreading information that is false to the extent that Alex Jones does. I mean, this is InfoWars level conspiracy theories that he's promoting on his podcast to millions of people. Now, again, you know, it's not just the COVID misinformation that solidifies his shift to the right. He's had other takes that are deeply stupid. I'm just going to go over this real quick here because I don't want to go back into the article, but he claimed that there's not a lot of overt discrimination against trans people. Joe Rogan, who I don't think has ever met a trans person until recently when he brought Blair White on his show, which is not the best trans person to, you know, learn from, he's saying that they don't experience overt discrimination. Oh, okay, okay, thank you. Thank you, Professor Rogan. He claimed that trans women use male tactics and male behavior as they invade feminist spaces. That's a real quote. Use male tactics and male behavior as they invade feminist spaces. So he's really, you know, he's cultivating this narrative that trans women are indeed predators, as we've been warned about from the likes of Fox News, Bill O'Reilly, you know, all throughout the years. He used the transphobic slur while saying you can't say it. So he said you can't say blank, but said it. And this is my favorite. He claimed straight white men eventually won't be able to talk if you give in to woke culture. Motherfucker is getting paid millions of dollars to just talk. And he's trying to portray people like himself as the victims. It's insufferable. So I don't know how you can't notice this. I don't know how you're not turned off by this, but thankfully people are noticing. Even people in Joe Rogan's own subreddit are realizing his brain is broken. Something's wrong. Now, there's still a substantial portion of Rogan's base on the subreddit that support him. And some of them push back about the criticism that he's been receiving. But one former Joe Rogan fan pushed back against the Joe Rogan fans that are still riding his dick hard with a Joe Rogan quote, which says that criticism is legitimate. Quote, everybody should be called on their bullshit, because when we say ridiculous shit, someone's supposed to go, bitch what? And if no one says bitch what, when you say ridiculous shit, you're hanging around with the wrong group of people. And that really is the perfect post, because it really fully encapsulates the problem with Joe Rogan. He's saying ridiculous shit, and outsiders like myself are saying bitch what, and he's not hearing it because he just surrounds himself with yes men. He'll say something and then whoever's on will just parrot it. And if he does bring on someone with a different opinion, not that I watch all the time, but you know, he will challenge them only if they don't play into his narrative of COVID misinformation and anti-vax hysteria. So, you know, it's sad that Joe Rogan has made this shift to the right. Again, I've never been a fan of Joe Rogan, but he wasn't necessarily considered too far gone based on what he said before. He kind of was politically ambiguous. That's the way that I've always viewed him, with a lot of really stupid reactionary takes. But now I think that Joe Rogan, he's too far gone. I mean, he's gone so far down the right-wing rabbit hole that he is essentially just another right-wing pundit. And that's sad, but the faster that people wake up and realize that this is the case, the quicker that people like him will stop being relevant.
When you're acting like a beta, 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 beta.